Hey, Chiefs Kingdom, welcome into the Chiefs Report. We got a mailbag coming up later this week, so use hashtag Chiefs, then ask your question to get your comments or questions on the show. Probably gonna film on Thursday, so you got a couple of days here, but make sure you use that hashtag Chiefs so we can find your questions, and I'll pick as many of them as possible for the Q&A later this week. Now, let's get into today's Chiefs Report. Let's talk about Josh Norman, the former Washington Redskin. He, of course, was released over the weekend by the Skins. He is available in free agency now, which is, what, about a month away, March 18th. And our good friends over at FanSided say that Norman would be a good fit on a prove-it deal. Now, we all know Kansas City doesn't have a ton of cap space to work with, and the focus is going to be primarily on Chris Jones, but question is Norman worth it? He's 32 years old, didn't play that great last year. Sure, he's still a skilled player, but is he what he used to be? I'm not so sure that he is. You look at his past four seasons, there's a reason Washington released him. He cost too much and he wasn't the same player in 2019. Now, we know he's a playmaker, always has a knack for intercepting passes, forcing fumbles is something he's always been good at, and creating turnovers is something every team could benefit from. And if Josh Norman could still do that, I'm all for it, but I'm just not so sure you're getting the Josh Norman that we've been used to over the last several years. I think there's been some decline there. But what do you guys think? Should the Chiefs sign Josh Norman this offseason? Type Y for yes, type in for no. Let me know what you guys think on whether or not Kansas City should sign Norman. Of course, a couple of free agents, Fuller and Breland and Mo Claiborne. So they don't get those guys back, Josh Norman could certainly be an option. All right, guys, you know the challenge. We're trying to get it to 1,000 subscribers by March 1st. I did the math. It's like less than 20 a day on our Chiefs Only channel. We can get there. It's a leap year. You got an extra day in February. Chatsports.com/Chiefs is the link to go. It'll redirect you to our Chiefs Only YouTube channel. We're going to have full offseason coverage. What's going to happen with Sammy Watkins? Patrick Mahomes' extension could be coming as well. Chris Jones, obviously. Lots of offseason rumors surrounding this team. I just released my top 15 free agent targets video. That is up on the channel as well. We've got draft coverage, mock drafts. I'll have a full 7-round mock draft in the near future as well. Chatsports.com/Chiefs. Plus, I'll give my three reasons why I don't think the Chiefs should sign Josh Norman. That video is already over on the Chiefs channel. Now, you look at the Chiefs secondary, the depth chart here, played a lot better the second half of 2019, but there's question marks heading into next year. Now, Tyrann Mathieu's under contract for a couple more years. Juan Thornhill, we'll see when he returns from that torn ACL. That's obviously a question mark. You feel good about Charvarius Ward on one side, but Breland's a free agent, Fuller's a free agent, Mo Claiborne's a free agent, so you possibly have some holes to fill, but I like what I saw from the rookie Rashad Fenton last season in limited snaps. I thought he played well. So who would you rather see play for this Chiefs? Who would you rather see get snaps in the secondary? Because if you bring on a guy like Josh Norman, you're taking snaps away from your young player Rashad Fenton. Now, if you don't think Fenton's ready for a bigger role, that's fine, but Fenton played better than Norman last year, guys. That's just a matter of the fact. Certainly less reps, but Washington benched Norman, and that was a very bad football team. So I am typing F for Fenton. I would like to see the young kid get more reps in 2020. Now, we still have a ton of Chiefs Super Bowl gear on sale for you guys. Got to go to the link, chatsports.com/ChiefsSB. Tons of different hats, lots of t-shirts over on the site with our partner Fanatics. Go to that link below, chatsports.com/ChiefsSB. I saw this zip-up jacket when I was perusing the website today. Might have to order me one of those. So lots of gear on sale for you guys. You can get the jerseys with the Super Bowl patch as well. All this stuff, you're not going to find a better price on it. Chatsports.com/ChiefsSB. Check the comments, check the description. We'll have it in there for you guys. It'll redirect you to this site so you can find all of this stuff. Now, I mentioned the Chiefs have some free agents at corners, and look, Fuller, Breland, Claiborne, don't focus as much on Claiborne, but A, Josh Norman is older than all these guys, and B, Fuller and Breland are objectively better players at this point in their careers. Now, there's a chance you can't keep both of them, so if you lose one and want to bring on Norman on board for a lesser role, maybe, but if you're expecting him to come in and start and be a primary cornerback, I don't think that's the route to go. I'd rather see Fenton get some reps, or maybe you draft a corner in April's draft if you need a number two corner opposite of Tarvarius Ward. I'm not crazy about the idea of bringing on Josh Norman. Thank you so much for watching the Chiefs Report. Now, if you want my three reasons why I don't think Kansas City should sign Norman, watch this video right here. Plus, if you want Chiefs coverage all offseason long, I'm talking about draft, free agency, news, rumors, we're going to have it on the Chiefs channel right here. Got to subscribe. Get us to 1,000 subscribers by March 1st. Go Chiefs.